Sunshine and a strong west wind greet Celtic and Clyde as they meet with the Scottish Cup final at Hampden before a crowd of well over 100,000. Clyde in white shirts kick off against the wind and attack straight away down the right wing. A speculative long-range shot gives Celtic their first bad moment. Clyde keep pressing, and now their winger Ring moves the ball across field and slips it to Lang in time to get it back for a snapshot. But it flashes just wide. Now the long ball attack up the middle, and Clyde's centre forward Ali Hill gets through very neatly, while goalie Bonner waits. And here it comes. Brown runs up, passes in. Hill takes a flying header, and it's in the net. But it's disallowed. It's still Clyde playing into the wind, but whatever they do doesn't seem to bother the record cup holders. And now it's Celtic turn, with Jimmy Walsh cutting through to slam it home. A great shot in the 38th minute of the game. Celtic, 17 times winner of the cup and the present holders, are one up. Looking a more compact side now, Celtic are after goal number two. A snapshot gives goalie Hewkins another bit of trouble, but he manages to cope. At half-time, it's still 1-0 for Celtic, and they start again on the attack. At last, veteran Tully gets the chance to show his paces as he rounds Murphy and centres, but the Celtic forwards fail to make the most of it. A nice pass from Robertson to Divers, and the Clyde forward line starts to move up the field on the attack. All goes well until a hearty kick by Horney sends the ball back into the Clyde half. Tully takes it down, but it goes into touch. The pressure stays on and Hewkins is in trouble again. He takes a fall and everybody gets in there. The referee Charlie Fortley steps in to calm things down. Some strong appeals and encouragement from the crowd, and Clyde get on top of the ball again. This time Bonner takes a fall. It's a rough game for the goalies this one, and Clyde force a corner. A lovely ball from Robertson swerves inwards and over Bonner's head. A goal, a beauty, an equaliser. One each, it finishes up. So the trophy will have to wait for the replay. After a one each draw, Clyde and Celtic meet again at Glasgow's Hampden Stadium for the replay of the Scottish Cup final. A crowd of nearly 70,000 see Clyde in white shirts kick off and begin to settle down for an early attack. But Celtic's left half Peacock steps in and sends his own line off. Walsh centres, but the quick-tackling Clyde defence secure the ball and get it safely into their goalie's hands, Ken Hewkins, who played such a grand game in the previous match. Clyde attacking now and looking good. Some nice football, but a long-range shot goes wide. Celtic's turn, a real ding-dong battle this, but the Clyde defence are in no danger. Away goes the ball again, and the forwards waste no time waiting for opportunities. Another long-range shot, but Bonner gets his hands to it. The corner finds a Clyde head. It rebounds off the bar to Diver's feet. He crashes it back, but the closely packed defence blocks it safely. Robertson falls over Bonner, and the goalie clears upfield. It's still no score by half-time. In the second half, the Celtic defence are still holding. A corner is cleared out to Tully, who takes it up the left wing. Good marking again stops Celtic, and the ball runs out of play. Both teams' defences have shown their best form so far. Clyde this time, but once more solid defensive work halts the attack, and play swings the other way. The Celtic breaks through, but not to score. Back in the Celtic half now, and Clyde are awarded a free kick, which is taken by left-back Harry Haddock. Both Ring and Bonner go for it. It rebounds off Ring, and it's a goal! The first and only goal of the match. For the first time, Celtic are beaten in a cup replay, and only the second time in their history, Clyde win the trophy. What a day for Clyde as captain Tommy Anderson holds aloft the cup, which his team have wrested from Celtic, the previous holders.